Hello.
This is the history. Can you hear me on? I'm a missions liaison officer with the Air Force Academy, volunteer position. But I also actually graduated from the Air Force Academy way back when, in 1997. And I had the distinct pleasure of also being a preppy back then. A really life-changing experience for me. I'm super, super excited for you guys. I live in St. Simon's Island, Georgia. This is my second time coming up here to participate in this wonderful event. When I was a candidate way back when in Oklahoma, we didn't have this. I was the first person in my high school to go off to a military service academy as well. So my parents love this. But at any rate, I'm just going to give you a little bit of the history about the challenge point, and then Lieutenant Forbes and I will get to work on this. Sound like a plan, Sam?
Yes.
Yes, all right. According to tradition, challenge points originated during World War I when a wealthy lieutenant in a newly formed flying squadron had a medallion struck in solid bronze and presented them to his unit. One young pilot placed the medallion in a small leather pouch that he wore around his neck. Shortly afterwards, the pilot was forced to land his damaged aircraft behind enemy lines. He was captured by German control, which seized all of his personal effects, except for the leather pouch, and was taken to a small French town near the front. During the bombardment that night, the young pilot escaped. He donned civilian attire to avoid German patrols. He reached the front lines and eventually stumbled onto a French outpost, but he was without personal identification. Saboteurs, often masquerading as civilians, had played the French in this sector. Not recognizing the pilot's American accent, the French thought him to be a saboteur and prepared to execute him. When the pilot produced a leather pouch containing the medallion, one of his captors recognized the squadron insignia. Instead of shooting him, the French gave him a bottle of wine. Back in the pilot's squadron, the challenge tradition was born. To ensure that all squadron members carried their medallion or coin at all times, a challenger would ask to see the medallion. A challenged airman who could not produce a medallion or coin was required to buy a drink for the member who challenged him. If the challenged airman produced a medallion, the member who initiated the challenge was required to buy the drink. This tradition continues today throughout all military operations. But don't underage drink.
Right. And really, don't underage drink. You will get kicked.
So I'm going to call the names up, and if you want, you know, your child in alphabetical order is coming.